dying, shouldn't hurt you, hear I'm crying. Can you practice what you preach? Would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us and some guidance from above. Cause right now people have me questioning, where is the
off to Brighton Beach to start celebrations of Lauren's birthday. So ready, and I was just lacking confidence to even start the intro of this video, but now the sun is out, we thank God. See you guys in Brighton. Water is so lovely, it looks green. So I'm excited for obviously walking around, taking pictures, then visiting the vintage stores I hear are in this beach or in this pier. I'm just trying to find where to park.
I wish I could have seen the future. All those years I was coming, just by stuff up and down.
Yeah.
But you don't know. So yeah, so okay, that's all.
Yeah. And you can even send the pictures once you snap them.
with the title, like what the bag is or what the jacket is.
But the problem is like some of those bags are so limited edition and some people know them.
You don't have to know, you just call it the name it is, that's it.
So like Alexander McQueen, blah blah blah.
Yes, whatever it was, if you have the receipt, just then you also say what you have. You have the dust bag, the receipt, whatever you
I have.
I have
dust bag and stuff.
Exactly, that's
but you know
it.
You said...
Take a picture with it.
You said even the bell, there's one belt I have, you can go, I don't need all those things.
Yeah,
there's
I said
one, but you know, you told me that I should check online and...
If you find a picture, yeah, that's just...
If I should check prices, I check, but they don't have the same thing. So
and
I'm
just
gonna
go
with
reasonable what?
Price, like
yeah,
half price.
Yeah, word.
Like the Burberry coats now, what is 350 is reasonable.
When you're even about to post it, eBay will tell you the current average price, selling price.
For the thing.
I tell you, but you can still put your own price. But you always tell you like what other sellers are selling, even if it's just the name or the shape of the bag, like a tote, yeah, Alexander, whatever.
Yeah.
Just tell you that, yeah, but
because I don't want to be greedy, I just
obviously
want
know what
to,
you
but
want
I also
to.
Don't want to make a stupid loss.
Yeah.
I don't want to make a loss.
I never even do bidding.
No,
things.
No bidding.
Yeah,
right,
so people
now.
Put their offer and then put offer. It's never just buy now. So you put a price and then people give you offer what they can pay. You check if you can accept it, fine. If not, you reject it.
Okay.
Jigger, so right now good, but also leave this chance for offers.
But what about and you've sold expensive stuff there before?
Yes.
And people got sick.
Yes. When I didn't have a job like 2 years ago, I sold like all the bags
it's
I ever had.
London,
yeah.
You can sell things like that.
Even Europe. Some they are international sellers. It's just that it's always advisable to use someone. Like, you know that Hermes I bought that you told me you wanted to buy.
Yeah.
I bought it from London and sold to someone in Italy.
Oh, it's someone.
Yeah, and obviously we all know that thing wasn't original, but it was mine. Bought for 200, sold it for 700.
But it was very convincing.
And it was too good. Like I checked everything on, even the way the zip seats, everything on YouTube on how to know a Hermes is original. Or it is, the guy didn't even return it, no complaint, nothing.
How much did you buy for?
200 or 180. I remember that. I told you that, you know, for 700.
Wow.
I tell you.
And it wasn't there for too long.
Wasn't where
he
wasn't
long.
There for
so
too
there
long.
People
were just asking. Yeah, there are some things that people look for. Those are those things that you can easily price anyhow. As I always say, check what. But then again, put your stuff, put your price. You just never know who's looking for that particular thing. Or
and I mean, no, like I would love to do it ASAP, but it's not as if it's the last money I'm depending on. Yeah. When I went to, because there's a train to
watching to this part of the video. That's it for my stay in Brighton. To be honest, I don't think there's any other thing to be done apart from walking around, eating and stuff. Vintage store I saw was nice, but I wasn't really ready to spend so much. The cheapest I saw there was £30 and the other nice, you know, designer stuff. But yeah, see you guys on the next episode. Please subscribe if you haven't, click the like button, drop a comment and share with your friends. See you on the next one. Bye bye.